transcribed.
Jerry?
Yeah?
Cigarette?
Certainly.
Chesterfield?
Exclusively.
King size?
Regular.
Light?
Thanks.
Good.
Splendid.
Ooh.
Which means that Chesterfield, first cigarette with premium quality in both regular and king size, brings you the Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis Show.
Chesterfield is best for you, much milder, better tasting too. They're today's best cigarette buy.
Come on, smokers, why don't you try?
Chesterfield,
best for you.
Chesterfield, best for you. Regular, king size, either way. Make it Chesterfield today.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to bring you our master of ceremonies, Dean Martin.
Thank you, and hi there, everybody. Well, we're all set to zip the little red cellophane strip off another Chesterfield pack of music and merriment. And while my partner Jerry is getting ready to extract some king-size laughs from the sleeve of his straight jacket, Richard, how about having ourselves a musical look into them their eyes?
I fell in love with you first time I looked into them, their eyes. You got a certain little cute way of flirting with them, their eyes. They make me feel happy, they make me blue. No stalling, I'm falling, going in a big wave of sweet little you. Oh, my heart is jumping, you sure started something with them, their eyes. You'd better watch them if you're wise. They sparkle, they bubble, they're gonna get you in a whole mess of trouble. You're overworking them, there's danger lurking in them, their eyes. Oh, my heart's jumping, you sure started something with their eyes. You'd better watch them if you're wise. They sparkle, they bubble, they're gonna get you in a whole lot of trouble. You're overworking them, there's danger lurking in them, their eyes.
Now, ladies and gentlemen...
Hey, Dean, hold on a minute.
Hold what a minute? What's the matter, Fenneman?
Well, a messenger just delivered a note from Jerry Lewis.
Oh, from Jerry? Let me see. Dear older than me, I'm running away from home because everybody picks on me. I'm going to China. In parting, let me say I love you, Dean. I love George Fenneman. I love Dick Stabile. I love Ethel for Blunget. I'm leaving all my worldly possessions. All I'm taking with me is a carton of Chesterfield.
Oh, gee, that's strange, Dean. At a time like this, why would Jerry take nothing but a carton of Chesterfields?
I love my sponsor, too.
It's Jerry Lewis! Well, Jerry, what made you change your mind about running off to China?
Oh, it's a long, long story, Deanie. I stood in a row for 3 hours with my thumb out waiting.
For what?
A car with Chinese license plates.
Jerry, you can't get to China that way. You get there by boat.
Then I must must have been standing on the wrong road, Dean. Very few boats passed by.
You know, I just don't understand it, Jerry. Why would you run away in the first place?
Well, Dean, it's just that I'm getting sick and tired of it all. People always hating me. Hating, hating, hating.
Jerry.
Hating, hating. Always Jerry. Hating. Never liking. Jerry. Always
Jerry.
Hating.
Jerry, stop.
And that goes for you too, Dean Martin.
What do you mean?
Stopping, stopping, always stopping. Never starting, always stopping.
Now cut it out.
Cutting, cutting, always
Oh, shut
cutting.
Up, will you? Look, Jerry, if there's something on your mind, I can help. Tell Deanie.
Well, you see, it's like this. It's my family again. They're all jealous of me because I have the mind of a 4-year-old. Oh.
Jerry, your family isn't jealous of you.
Oh, they are so too, Deanie. Why, when I was born, the very first time my mother looked at my face, she was jealous.
Jealous of what?
Other mothers.
Oh, please, Jerry.
Oh, yeah, when I was a baby, I was all wrinkled up like a prune.
Jerry, lots of tiny babies look like a prune.
With a pit in the middle.
Well, I see what you mean. And it's enough to give a kid a complex.
Oh, yes, indeed. How would you like to go through life trying to spit yourself out?
Believe me, Jerry, you're all wrong about this. I happen to know your family loves you.
Oh, yeah? Then how about my mother? Her, how about?
She didn't like you?
You want I should give you a for instance?
Yeah. Give a for instance.
All righty. And this one is the positive darb. Oh. Every time I cried at night, my mother used to take me in her arms and rock me to sleep.
Well, why should that make you think your mother doesn't love you?
She used real rocks.
Oh.
And Dean, ask me about toys. Ask me about toys.
Okay, about toys.
I'm glad you brought that up. Until I was 3 years old, I never had any toy.
No toy? Didn't you have a rattle?
Only when I walk.
Yeah. But, Jerry... Jerry, you may be the ugly duckling of the family, but I'll always be your friend.
Ho-ho, somebody.
What have you ever done for me? What have you?
What have I ever done for you? What have I? I'll tell you what I've done. I fixed up a date for you with Janet Lee, Ginger Rogers, and Marilyn Monroe.
Blondes, blondes, always blondes. Don't you think a guy likes to go out with a brunette once in a while?
Jerry, believe me, I'm actually your pal.
Fine pal. If you're my pal, how come you never call me anymore?
Well, you don't have a phone.
I know, but you have.
Look, Jerry, if you don't like this arrangement between you and me, you can call the whole act off.
Okay, let's call it quits.
Quit?
You heard me, K-W-I-T-Z. Quit.
You mean it, Jer?
Sure, I can get along fine on my own. I can always go back to what I was doing before I met you.
You can, huh?
Yeah.
All right, go back to what you were doing before you met me.
Okay.
Well?
Shine your shoes, mister?
No.
Years ahead of them all. Chesterfield is years ahead of them all. The quality contrast between Chesterfield and other leading brands is a revealing story. Recent chemical analyses give an index of good quality for the country's 6 leading cigarette brands. The index of good quality table, which is a ratio of high sugar to low nicotine, shows Chesterfield quality highest.
Chesterfield quality highest.
15% higher than its nearest competitor.
Chesterfield quality highest.
31% higher than the average of the 5 other leading brands.
Yes, Chesterfield is first with premium quality in both regular and king size.
Don't you want to try a cigarette with a record like this? Chesterfield.
Ladies and gentlemen, though we're not scientists, Jerry and I tried a little experiment not too long ago. We were anxious to see what would happen if we mixed comedy and drama in one picture. Well, out of the test tube came our latest picture, The Stooge. And Jerry and I are really thrilled that so many of you are visiting your local theaters to see it. And since we're on the subject of chemistry, I'm ready to mix some lovely words with a haunting refrain.
Pretend you're happy when you're blue. It isn't very hard to do. find happiness without an end whenever you pretend. Remember, anyone can dream, and nothing's bad as it may seem. The little things you haven't got could be a lot if you pretend. You'll find the love you can share, one you can call all your own. Just close your eyes, she'll be there. You'll never be alone. And if you sing this melody, you'll be pretending just like me. The world is mine, it can be yours, my friend. So why don't you pretend?
Before I introduce the guest star, Jerry, I want to make sure of something. Is everything straightened out between us?
Yes, indeedy, Mr. Martin, sir. You're the boss.
And you?
And I'm nothing.
Now, don't forget that. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the part of the program that I always look forward to.
Some job he's got. Boss over nothing.
This is the part of the program where I introduce the guest star.
Believe me, they won't always say, "There goes Jerry Lewis, the idiot."
Our guest is...
I'm going to go to college.
Our guest
when is... When I graduate from college, they won't say, "There goes Jerry Lewis, the idiot," anymore.
Our guest
They'll
is...
say, "There goes Professor Lewis, the idiot."
Look, Jerry, I've had enough of your interruptions.
What do you want me to do?
Who cares? Play jacks with George Fenneman.
What a splendid idea.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, a command performance. Tonight's guest star appeared with us earlier this season, but because of her beauty, charm, and talent, and your reaction to the same, we practically command her to return. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Linda Darnell.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much, Dean. Hey, say, where's Jerry?
With Fenneman. Jerry, come here. You remember Linda Darnell?
Oh, indeedy-dee, I do, Deanie darling. Miss Darnell's the girl with the two most beautiful legs in the world.
Why, Jerry, how do you know I've got the two most beautiful legs in the world?
I counted them.
Well, Jerry, Linda's a Texas gal, and that's the way Texas gals are built.
Then my geography book is all wrong.
Well, what do you mean, Jerry?
Texas never had a shape like that.
You know, Linda, we've asked you here for a specific purpose. Jerry and I have been working together for a long time.
Oh, I know, Dean, and I think it's just wonderful. You've given Jerry half of everything from the first dollar you made.
Yeah, and someday he promised to give me half of the rest of the money we made.
Oh, come on, please, Jerry. Linda, for years, Jerry and I have been chasing all over the United States, and all over Canada, and all over Europe, and we've just decided we'd like to have you in the act.
But why me? Well, what'll I do in the act?
Oh, I'm sure we can figure out some sort of a novelty for you in the act.
Yeah, we can do a magic act, Miss Darnell. You get in the trunk.
Yes.
And I get in there with you.
That's magic?
It is if I can get away with it.
Now, I got an idea. We'll do an adagio act. Now, picture the setting. A dive in Paris. I pick Linda up, and I throw her to you.
This I like.
Well, what does Jerry do?
He holds you in his arms for a second, then he throws you back to me.
You want to bet?
Now, during the dance, there's a struggle. Tables crash, chairs break, shots are fired.
Well, Dean, what are you doing all this time?
I'm singing.
But through all the gunshots, tables crashing, and chairs breaking, how can you continue singing?
Oh, it's easy. I'm used to Dick Stabile's orchestra.
Well, Darnell, I just thought of a finish for the act. While I'm lying there on the floor, you take me in your arms and kiss me.
Well, that sounds swell, but what'll you do for an encore?
Break out in goose pimples.
Well, I'm sorry, boys, but look, that adagio stuff is out. You know, I've got an idea, though. I've done so many tropical island pictures. Why don't we do a satire in one of those?
That suggestion's a dive, a complete dive.
Let's try one right now. Fenneman, get us going.
Right, Dean. Ladies and gentlemen, the Chesterfield... Ooh, you'll like them, players. Now present Dean Martin, Jerry Lewis, and Linda Darnell in the first of a series of shipwreck jokes. It is the stark drama of two men cast adrift on a tiny raft in the South Pacific. For days, they drift beneath the blistering sun, dying from thirst, slowly going mad, bodies emaciated with hunger. And all they have with them is Linda Darnell. Entitled... Should Happen to Me.
On this raft anymore. Can't stand it. I'm rotting away, I tell you. Rotting, rotting. How long have we been adrift?
10 minutes.
Well, I spoil quickly.
I can't stand this horrible thirst anymore.
Me neither. Just look at my lips. They're all blistered.
Oh, you poor boy. Let me kiss you again.
How do you think they got blistered?
I need water. Water, I need water. Where's our water?
Oh, good heavens, our water is all gone.
Yeah, I used the last drop.
To drink?
No, to wash my dainties.
Hey, fellas, this is the beginning of the end. Look, there's a leak in our rubber raft.
Quick!
Leaking out.
Then put a balloon under it.
Hey, that's a good idea. We may not have food to eat and water to drink, but we'll always have air to breathe.
Don't worry, we won't go hungry. This morning I caught a fish.
But what did you use for a hook?
Dean's old nose.
But Jerry, what did you use for bait?
There was enough left over for that, too, I guess.
Oh, look. Look out there, a ship.
Is it a sloop? Right.
They must have seen my petticoat that I hung on the mast. They're signaling.
What are they saying?
Lady, your slip is showing. Look! Oh, look!
Aren't you overacting just a little
bit? A little bit, yeah. Look! A tiny island.
Where?
Way out there where I'm pointing.
That's no island. You got a wart on the end of your finger.
I'll dive overboard.
Well, here we are on the island.
We certainly swam here fast.
We had to keep up with the music.
This island must be inhabited. There are footprints all along the beach.
Yes. Yes, but the prints are only of 1 foot. Who could be living here?
Only one man. Hop along, Cassidy.
Hey, fellas, I know where we are now. We're on the island of the headhunters. They shrink heads down to the size of olives.
What are they use them for?
Martinis.
That figure.
Oh, pish and tosh. If there are any headhunters within 100 miles of here, my name is William Shakespeare. Oh, what a rogue in peasant's name. Is it not monstrous that the player here?
Look! Oh, look! An arrow is sticking out of the top of your head.
I don't want them to know they've got me. Quick, pull the arrow out.
We can't pull it out.
Then quick, hammer it in.
I can tell by the marking on that arrow that we're in the land of the Ugga Mugga Jugga Wugga Lugga Dugga Bugga tribe.
The Ugga Mugga Jugga Wugga Lugga Dugga Buggas? Are they friendly?
Only to other Ugga Mugga Jugga Wugga Lugga Dugga Buggas.
They must know we're here. They're sending up smoke signals.
Well, what are they saying?
I don't know. In school, I flunked smoke. Oh.
Oh, look, here comes the cannibal chief. Oh, just look at him. He's hideous.
Why are you so amazed? All cannibals have their faces painted.
Painted, I can understand, but wallpaper?
Never.
I'll talk to the chief. Maybe we can escape with our lives. Chief, I'm Jerry Lewis.
Unga munga bunga doo.
I'm Dean Martin.
Unga munga bunga doo.
I'm Linda Darnell.
Unga munga bunga doo. Ma'am.
Chief, you've been looking me over. Why?
Me, champion cannibal.
Well, it looks like me going to be breakfast the champion.
Chief, when you cook me, don't use butter. I'm on a diet.
No, you. We sauté. Then mix with minced actor.
Oh, I must send this recipe home to my mother. She's never tasted a people pizza.
Me fix up little one for snack. First pour mushroom overhead. Put carrot in ears. Grated parsley on forehead. Melt the cheese over face.
Look, he's pouring brandy sauce all over my chest.
There, now, everything ready.
Ah!
Oh, Jerry. Jerry, what happened?
I couldn't help it. I couldn't help it.
Couldn't help what?
I looked so delicious, I took a bite out of myself.
Don't you want to try a cigarette with a record like this?
The first choice of young America, according to a recent survey made in 274 colleges. Chesterfield.
The first cigarette with premium quality in both regular and king size. Chesterfield.
The cigarette with highest quality, proven by chemical analyses to have higher quality than the five other leading brands. Chesterfield.
And first, to give you this report. A doctor has been making thorough examinations of a group of Chesterfield smokers every 2 months for a full year. And he reports no adverse effects to the nose, throat, and sinuses from smoking Chesterfield. Try Chesterfield. Buy a carton. Much milder Chesterfield is America's best cigarette buy.
You know, there are old songs, and then there are songs that never grow old. The kind that people return to time after time and year after year. As one of the people, here's my nomination for one of the songs I'd most like to hear more often. I dream of you more than you dream I do. How can I prove to you this love is real? You're mean to me more than you mean to be. You just can't seem to see the way I feel when I am close.
close to you. The world is far away. The words that filled my heart, my lips can seem to say. So more than you'll ever know, more than you dream I do. I dream of you.
Wonderful. You know, that's just the kind of song and singing I love to hear.
Well, thank you, Linda. You're very sweet.
Yeah, now, Miss Darnell, how about signing that contract to work with us in the act?
Yeah, Linda, we can park up on Inspiration Point and discuss your problem.
Well, I don't have any problem.
You're not up on Inspiration Point yet.
Jerry, you shouldn't try to give Linda the impression that I'm a wolf.
That's silly, Dean. You're not a wolf.
Of course not.
You're an octopus.
Oh, that's ridiculous, Jerry. An octopus is something that has eight arms.
You're not up on Inspiration Point yet.
Well, maybe I'd better go home by myself.
Well, if you insist, but really, Linda, it's been a real pleasure to have you with us again.
It sure has, Miss Darnell. Please don't stay away too long.
I won't, fellas. Good night, Dean. Good night, Jerry.
Good night,
good night.
Linda.
Good night, Miss Darnell.
Hey, Jer, how about that quality contrast between Chesterfield and the other leading brands?
Yeah, Chesterfield quality is highest.
Sort of makes you wonder why anybody would smoke anything but Chesterfield's, doesn't it?
You said it.
Honest friends, if you want the best, there's no doubt about it. Chesterfield's the one for you.
Try those Chesterfields tomorrow, folks. You'll see what we mean. They're best for you.
So until next week, this is Dean Martin.
And this is Jerry Lewis saying good night,
God
everybody.
God bless you.
Just heard transcribed the Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis Show, produced and directed by Dick Mack, written by Arthur Phillips and Austin Kalish, with music prepared and conducted by Dick Stabile. And this is George Fenneman reminding you to listen to Chesterfield's award-winning show, Dragnet, Sunday night on this same NBC station.
Now, new Fatima has the tip for your lips. Fatima tips of perfect cork. King size for natural filtering. Fatima quality for a much better flavor and aroma. So remember, new Fatima has the tip for your lips. Fatima. See how smooth they are.
Remember, Fatima is made by the makers of Chesterfield, Liggett and Myers, one of tobacco's most respected names.
Linda Darnell will soon be seen in the RKO production Second Chance, co-starring with Robert McGill.
Tonight, visit Fibber McGee and Molly on NBC.